Okay, this is the dance troupe video for your guys' makeup. This is a really interesting. I like this look the most. I think it's one of my favorites. Just because this is what I like when it comes to makeup. This kind of like grungy looking clustery thing. First thing you're gonna do is you are going to take your natural brow color, and you are going to take your brows and you are gonna go real thick with them. I mean, full on bush brows. Like, it does not have to be the prettiest brow of your life because you guys are undead. And therefore, you do not go get your brows done twice a week. That sounds like a lot. Like, ooh, twice a month, that's what I meant to say. So, you have bushy, old brows that have not been done in a hot minute. So, real big brows, and then just brush them a little bit. So, there's the brows. You guys are gonna start off with a mostly white face. I don't have any of the white base that you guys will be using. I'm not picking my nose, I promise. Just scratching it. I do not have any of the white base, so I can't show you guys the white, but you can see everything else that I'll show you. Basically, you're gonna put on the white all over your face, blend it down your neck to match wherever your neckline is on your costume, and then set that with powder first before you do anything else. Then you're gonna go in with some cream product. You're gonna start off with a blue color. This is the blue Ben Nye beautiful thing. Gonna grab my makeup sponge here. You guys, oh crud, I just dropped it. That went well. Almost just dropped it again. Okay, so you're gonna start with a blue. You're gonna take the little spongy guy, or you can take your fingers. I don't care, whatever works for you. And you're gonna start going in under your eyes here. The reason you're gonna start off with the blue is because that's gonna add this first layer. And notice how splotchy it's going on? That's perfect. You don't want it to be super perfect and like one giant streak of blue. You're gonna take that and put it under your eyes, bring it onto your nose a little bit like that. And then you're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Really stamp it in the center, really focus it in the center, and then work it out a little bit. The whole goal of this is just to add this really nasty, bruisey look to your face. So start off with this blue. That's about all the blue you really need. And then you're gonna go in with a gonna go in with a green color. And the green you're gonna put on top of the blue very lightly. Go easy with the green, because you don't want to put too much green in there. Because otherwise it'll start to look weird. So really kind of focus the green in the areas where you're missing blue. Like the blue is not 100% there. It's gonna add that nasty look to it. And then also take the green and apply that all up under your eyebrow. Again, this green is a kind of a crucial part in this look, actually. You might not think so looking at it right now. You're like, this is weird. You look like a crazy person trying to be a peacock on Halloween. Well, fun fact. I'm not trying to be a crazy Halloween kid. Then you're gonna take a black and literally the tiniest amount. Literally, I just barely squeezed it and I got the smallest little amount, like a dime size. Not even. You're gonna take a little bit of that and you're gonna start by applying it just onto the part where you can feel your eyeball. This is a liquid product, so this one's gonna blend a little bit more. And then you start to, once you get the color concentrated in that area, work your way down and around. Then you can take your little sponge guy and just start to work that around the edges. Okay, and this sponge should have some of the green still left on it, so it should still give that look. Then you're gonna go into your eye, and you really want your eyelid to be 100% black, black, black. Like that. Like, you want to look like you got... The whole goal of this is just to look like you haven't slept in probably what feels like years. You know, good old times. Again, go in with your little spongy guy. Blend that out before it dries. And this does not have to be the most blended, beautiful thing on the face of this earth. Trust me, it won't be, so don't worry about it. But close is better than nothing. I said this in my last video that I just filmed. I'm apologizing ahead of time. I sound sick, and I think I'm starting to come down with something, so that's a fun time. Again, I'm doing the same, basically just repeat the same steps that you did on your other eye over here. Now, I will say this much. Try and make sure that your sides are pretty even when it comes down to shape, like overall shape. Ooh. There we go. Because you want it to look... It does not matter if they're blended to the gods or anything like that. That doesn't matter. But you want the overall shape to be pretty much the same on both sides. So again, this is going to have kind of that greenish undertone to it, which is going to help really add that nasty look overall. You'll also have some purple. Go ahead and add that on top of your black. That's going to add kind of just this, it's going to really enhance that bruised effect that we're really striving towards here. Yeah, a little fun tip about me. I make a lot of strange noises when I'm trying to do something. So if y'all are hearing or anything weird like that. I'm taking a purple eyeshadow. You guys, I think we'll have a purple cream supplied. But you're going to apply that really around that eye, kind of on top of where you put the black initially before you started blending it. And again, this is just going to help enhance, one, it'll help enhance the black, and two, it'll also just really add to that bruisey effect. And then same thing as when you did the black, once you have like nothing left, blend it kind of into that green. So you see... Let me get closer. So I've got this purple on top of the black here. You can see the green kind of poking through in certain areas. You can see the blue sometimes. It really depends, but this is going to help just add that nasty grungy. So again, on the other side. On top where that black went. There we go. Yep, that is kind of the look we're going for here. And then, my nose itches. Take that purple shade, and again, you're going to take it and you're going to, this is what you're contouring with, you're going to take it and you're going to contour literally like that. And then you're going to take it also and just go. So you're going to kind of follow your natural contour shape and then cut down like that. Don't worry, we're blending this out in a second, so don't worry too much. Really get those cut into there. Basically, what you're following is kind of just like a natural shape of your face. Oh, and they're not even, but that's okay. They don't have to be perfect. Then you're just gonna take a little brush, or your fingers, I'm gonna use a brush, and you're just gonna slightly blend that out. Take your face powder if you need to blend it, but just work it. The trick to this look specifically, which is kind of cool but kind of a pain in the butt, is just the trick is the blending and the amount of blending that it requires, because that's how you're gonna get this specific look to look about as good as it can. Then take that same purple color and you're gonna apply it right along your hairline. This is just going to create that nasty, sunken in, I'm already dead kind of look. So again, that same side, other side, I don't know why I said same side. It's late and I'm a very tired grandma. And then again, you're also gonna take that and you're gonna blend it under your jawline, because you want to look like you, another thing is you want to look like you haven't eaten in like 5 days. 5 days? I mean like 5 weeks, what am I talking about? So just, yeah, get it all in there, and then take a little bit, go under your lip, right there. Again, that's gonna add more to this overall thing. Then, once you get all that done, oh, I look scary. I like it. You're gonna take your concealer color, so, or your foundation shade, whatever, and you're gonna apply it to your lips. This is not normal for most people, so I would totally understand. You want your lips to be basically non-existent. You want them to blend in to your face. And I know that's not what most of us want to do, but so yeah, this is the overall look for the dance troupe. It's creepy, it's grungy, it's so fun. And see, the nice thing is with the bushy brows is it gives you like a nice little outline for your eye makeup. Again, it doesn't have to be like 100% perfect and all that jazz. It just has to be pretty darn close. So, here is the overall look. Hope y'all have fun with this one. I know I love this look the most. I think this is one of my favorites from the whole show. So have fun with it. Just have fun with it, no matter what you do. All right, have a good day.